So, hello everyone, by Groomer DK. We will now look a little how to smooth stripped areas to clipped areas and how to make the coat in one nice jacket from this a little shabby. This was someone eating on the floor. So, we start with the head. Here you see that he had been clippered like 2 weeks ago. And I'm not clipping him now on the ears because it's minus 14 outside, so it's not so smart. But we will take all this shapi away. And from our great repertoire, I will start with the diamond because the diamond will do. So it's the diamond course. And we start between the eyes. And we take on top of the head. You go a little over there, then you can better see. Because this is really detailing work on top of the head and the smooth way to the cheeks. He has some longer hair there and there because it's the price for the rolling. So you have a little there and a little there, which the diamond is cleaning very well. And lie down if you want to protest. So, and now there is coming some undercoat, so if we want to clean it, we will take the classic fine. And clean all this. This is the super fine, the little clever tool. So now we smoothed it all the way around. Then just take a little there and there. The last pieces. Between the eyes, we are stripping this. We are not clipping it because this I will take the diamond for. Because there is not coming so nice coat if you clip it. See how it cleaned it. And and it needs a little more here. Good boy. And we have beautiful stop marked with a wire coat. And we can clean a little from it. It's already done. And now we move on to the side of the neck. There I'm also using the super fine and the diamond. Because you need really to go details. You have to use it on the throat too. Because you can't just clip short and then expect that it will blend together. Then you take the diamond and you take all the long stop, stop. And then just cream, so you have only the wire part. Now it's already nicely blended together. You simply have to pull what is on each side and wool in between, so you have it. Let's see how pretty. The issue actually by miniature schnauzer is to groom him so he would look like he wasn't groomed, like it grew like that. Like it was simply he was born with this. And here also I have a little more on the neck because this I stripped a little more forward, and a little junk on the back which I need to get rid of. So this you will meet, especially if you don't have the dogs at home or something. Then I had him at home, but I was doing different things, so I let it to overgrow a little. And there you have to be a little more creative because there isn't enough to roll now on this part. And here is a little too much. So you have to think now, okay, I want to get him back to rolling coat. So I will take a roller. And this I will take the classic coarse. And I will take a load now. How can you see it best? Because when we take nice load, it also overgrowed a little on the shoulders and here on the. And not take too much because I need to go back into the nice rolling coat. It's all this time that we were not showing, so I didn't pay so much attention to the coat. And it's good for you now to see how to get it back because it's easy to come to perfectly roll the dog and then just say okay. But you have to start somewhere. So you just take with the double teeth one with very light hand. A little load, and it shouldn't take you more than 10 minutes or so, because you shouldn't strip him totally. You need the coat to start to renew. And especially here on the neck, he got a lot, so there you can take a little more. You have to think all the time, okay, I have to do a little there to make the coat growing under. So we got a nice here, short, and then okay, there is still a little undercoat, so I will take the rainbow fine to give it a little push. He has a very wire coat, so the knife, you have to be really secured that it will not cut. And it's very visible that this knife is not cutting one single hair. And it takes the undercoat. I cannot take so much from him because he loves to sit outside, so he will be a little cold. You also remember it's dogs. You shouldn't strip them totally naked when it's minus 15 degrees. They should be dogs. So also when you remove the undercoat, do it in good time before the show, because they need a little undercoat. It's double coated breed and the judges demand it. So give it 2 weeks before show to remove undercoat, so there is some undercoat saved for it. How the coat improved just on this little time. You can as well use the diamond for the rolling if you just want a little on the top. It simply takes great, this knife. I love this. This knife is really God's gift. So now we rolled him a little nicely on this. There is also some undercoat. Remember, if you clean the undercoat, light the knife, totally following the coat down. And as I said before, when you should have the stripping area, you are going from a little under the elbow down from here, and then from the flank, like you lie the knife to edge of the hook, like this. All this up is going to be stripped, all this down is going to be saved and clipped. And this, I think, it will be the next video. I will show you how to clip the legs, because there was a lot asking to do that. When you pull the coat with a stripping knife, never do this. This is so damn important, because if you do this, however unsharp is the knife, you risk it will cut. Well, this one didn't, but it's because it's ours. So if you pull with the knife, you have to keep the wrist. Just think you have the hand in gips. You can't turn it. And then you pull like this. You use your shoulder. You use your shoulder and you use your elbow. You have totally dead wrist when you strip. So you just pull. You keep with the thumb up some of the hair and you pull. And if you are a little unsure if you can do it or not, take one of these, the diamond, and you can't damage anything. And it will do the job as well as the stripping knife. It will take a lovely portion. So this is a smart way if you are a little unsure on yourself with the stripping knife. Then use the stripping knife just to clean the undercoat and use the diamond to take. And you can use you can turn however you want to. It never breaks anything. So this is the issue, always not to break, because clipped hair is not working the same way as a pulled out hair. And this is the whole secret of stripping dogs, to pull the hair and get this. You can as well use the classic fine for cleaning the coat. Now we almost have no undercoat here, so also very important that it doesn't cut. That it's lovely. All the roots are secured. If it pulls a hair, it pulls it out. And here I left a little too much, so this we have to. So we can have the legs prepared for the next work. And I know you will enjoy to look how to clip the legs. So this is the next lesson. Here you can take a little from the elbow, because it never should stick out. So this makes it nice. Nice coat. However, I didn't have so much time on it. We smoothed it and we did it. So he can actually go on show with this coat now. Because it's just a decent jacket for show around 2 centimeters. And if you keep rolling, you will keep show jacket all the year through. And maybe we will be so lucky we will have shows again. So who is prepared is not surprised. So we have to start rolling now. And in 2-3 months, we have perfect coat. And I will be happy if you make some videos of your dogs, if you will send it to us or post it on our page. We will be really happy to see, and we will gladly give you free advices. If you need any advices, just write us or send us some photo and ask, because we have been using over 32 years to learn this, and now it's on time to give it on and help all of you to do the right job with your dogs. So that's the important part from this coat care. We say thank you for your time, and Red is saying bye bye.